Okay, so we're here today talking with Jake Siegel, who is the founder of Livio Radio.
Yep.
And one of the main guy behind the 360 project that is being proposed here in downtown Ferndale. Can you tell us a little bit about the project that you're working on?
Yeah, I'm really excited. We've been working with the city for talking about a big idea around bringing in more jobs into Ferndale for about the past couple years. And for the past 6-8 months here, we've put together a nice agreement with the city, and we're going through a process to figure out what we can bring to downtown to bring in more jobs.
Now, your plan is taking existing parking lots and then doing what with them?
Well, because it's a mixed use development with a partnership with the city needs to add additional parking to help the businesses, help the downtown, and help residents as well to get some of the parking in the residential communities, you know, more on the city parking property. So the city has really been driving the parking, which is what really put the project here in the first place. What I'm really focused on is creating more jobs in the area, and we focus on STEM jobs. So we're looking at, you know, primarily software engineers, but, you know, anyone, science, technology, engineering, math, and helping bringing more of that STEM growth right here to southeastern Michigan.
Do you think that there is going to be job growth, and is this like technology-based jobs?
Yes, it is, and that's the reason we're doing this. So, you know, I've never been a real estate developer before. I owned and started a tech company, and you know, my background is around hiring top talent and understanding the right mix of culture and creatives and all the ingredients it makes to really have an awesome work-life experience. So, what I'm really looking for out of this project is creation of jobs and really maintaining that Ferndale fit and culture. And it's the reason why I chose to move here from New England, and the reason I chose to start my business here, and why I'm working on a development project here. I think the parking and the residential components really fits the city well, and a lot of that had to do with our work with the city and came up with those plans. And obviously the city has the parking, and it's the city's parking lot. But from a job creation standpoint, I'm very excited about the opportunities that are here in southeastern Michigan. I think Ferndale is an amazing place to bring in more tech jobs.
So for people who aren't familiar with your company that you started before, what can you tell us about that?
Well, I started Livio in my guest bedroom. It was actually called Mine Electronics in 2008, just down the street. And I lived in Ferndale, lived here with my wife. And we sold that company, fast forward 6 years later, to Ford last September, end of September, early October last year. And we started off making original radios for Pandora, and I had this desire to help my mom get Pandora radio around the home without calling me for help. So at the time, no one even knew who Pandora was, and we had to, people were using their laptops to go around. And now, to be clear, we're not Pandora. A lot of people think that we were the Pandora company. We just made a product, an actual desktop radio the size of a toaster, that let anybody, from grandparents to grandkids, get access to Pandora. And I did all this right out of my home in Ferndale. And as we grew, I picked up an office in Hilton, Ferndale. And then we got into software with the iPhone and Android phone. And we hired a really awesome team. And we're working with universities like Michigan State, Kettering, and Lawrence Tech, and University of Michigan. And I just really fell in love with the potential that southeastern Michigan has. So selling the company to Ford and transitioning out of that business, I've recently started a new software company, which is, you know, my full-time job, and I'm spending a lot of hours clearly on this project, and it's a multi-year project for Ferndale. So I think that my experience and understanding the culture, understanding the fit, why I moved here, why a lot of other people continue to live here and are here, just bringing more of those jobs into Ferndale and strengthening southeastern Michigan is really what it's all about.
So what is it about Ferndale that makes this the ideal spot for this?
You know, I think it's like all the knobs are in the right place. So, you know, you could look at any city and say, like, these are the best things about one city, and these are the things that are challenges. And you couldn't do a project like this in most areas in Detroit. And I like to call this One Detroit. I tell people, like, you know, I travel around the world that, you know, I live in Detroit. And, you know, when I'm here, I tell people I live in Ferndale. But nobody knows where Ferndale is, and it's not on the map. And it's very similar to what we've seen in other cities around the United States, where you have this sense of community. And I think what Ferndale can offer is a really creative, culturally appropriate, fresh, very young at heart feeling city, where everybody is very passionate and cares a lot about how things happen. And we've clearly seen that just even going through this process. And even though clearly I don't agree with everybody's opinion on this, I'm just excited. And one of the reasons I'm even doing this here is that everybody cares so much about this area. And that's one of the most special things about the area, is just the amount of energy that you get when you enter the 9 and Woodward corridor.
So there have been some criticisms to this project and kind of how it's going along. What are some of the things that people have brought up that that maybe they don't see the same vision as you?
Well, there's a lot of there's been a lot of comments, positive, negative, vocally at our events. We heard a mix of both, but I think what it really comes down to is what's the appropriate way to do a project like this. Clearly, there's some folks that, you know, are just never going to like this project, and that's fine. I mean, there's certain things that happen in business and in my life that, you know, I'm never going to like and agree with, and, you know, it is what it is. But for what we've seen so far is that we're getting really good feedback about if this is going to happen and if these jobs are coming into Ferndale, what's the right way to do it? What are the most important issues that we need to address? So my team, as well as the city and the DDA, have been very focused on going through the process. So one of the biggest criticisms we've heard is that it's already been made up, our minds are made up, this process is already going, and really just, you know, that's one thing that needs to be cleared up, is that we're going through that process, and I made the decision with the city, with DDA, that we were going to run a transparent and open way for everybody to provide feedback. And we've gotten a lot of noise, clearly, but we've gotten some really good signals, some really good feedback on what are important features, what are some important ways about phasing, what's the parking plan, all these important things that we want to understand where people stood. And there are kind of three basic types of folks. There are people that are residents, there are people that are property owners that own business properties, own homes, and there are people that are small business owners. And sometimes people wear both hats. I wear two. You know, obviously I wear a hat as a business owner. I also wear a hat as a property owner because I live here. So there's definitely different feelings and different things going on, but I think the biggest thing we've got out of this is that Ferndale's got a lot of passion about the way this is going to go, and certainly there's been a lot of opinions, but we've also gotten a ton of support. And I think for anyone that cares about jobs and is looking at what's Ferndale going to look like 20, 30, 40, 50, 100 years from now, we want to make sure that the first step is the right step, and that's really what we're focused to do here.
So you've had a couple of forums already, and you're working with the city and the planning commission and all of that. What is the next step for this?
Well, right now, from a social perspective, like we've had our town hall meetings as planned, and I thought they were executed flawlessly. I think the mayor did a tremendous job. The city council did a tremendous job. Certainly the DDA and Christina over at the DDA did an amazing job putting everything together and just making sure that we kept an orderly format. And Michelle from the city did a great job getting everybody's feedback and making sure that there's a website set up, and we're going through that process. So I think we've finished that initial phase. So what we're doing with our development team is we're going through the negotiating process. So as many people have heard, we're negotiating a contract with the city. So we have I have a development team, including of people I have. I mean, I know I have a background as a developer. You know, I'm a tech guy. So we put together an all-star team of people with decades of experience doing real estate development and construction and, you know, all the things that go into a deal of this size. So they're going in with the city, and we're working out all the details around financing and, you know, the size and the planning commission and all those types of technical aspects. So now that we've gotten some good feedback, we're using that feedback to go through the program and planning phases, and then we'll be back in the city in the fall in front of city council and planning commission with the next steps.
Now, some of the concern has been about the design of the project, like how it looked on the renderings that came out, and there's been a lot of feedback on that. Are you listening to public feedback, and is there still going to be options for people to kind of weigh in on that stuff?
Of course. And, you know, one thing that was almost a little bit funny is we've said so many times that we have not made designs yet, but that everybody kind of feels, not everybody, but some people feel like we've already made the design, and that just isn't the case. Like, we have not done the designs yet. We haven't chosen materials. We haven't gone through that. We've done some benchmarking, which means like going on different areas around the world and looking at things that we like and things that look great. I mean, I have a vision for the design that I think is going to look best, but clearly, and that vision has not been shared with the world and has not been shared in the presentations. We just made a decision that instead of showing big white boxes on a presentation, that at least put something up with some people. So an average person that doesn't have a background in engineering or construction or real estate could kind of see what we're talking about doing. So it's a little unfortunate. It's a bit of a double-edged sword, where if we showed white boxes, people would say we weren't serious. But if we showed something that was a preliminary concept and not a design, then people would jump on this color or this thing here or that thing there. So the real goal was to get that kind of feedback. And if it doesn't fit Ferndale, I'm not interested in doing it. I mean, that's just, at the end of the day, that's not what this is about. This has to fit and hug the community.
So was that more of like architectural, like space type things and feature type things, as opposed to like design stuff, right?
Yes. So the what we showed in the presentation was just about what goes where, the potential elevation levels, the potential where the parking is. I mean, just the massing of the building. So having like, you know, a building right where we're sitting that is the apartments, which provides a little bit of like visual relief. So the residents have apartments before they hit the parking decks. And then having where the offices is and just kind of where things go. I mean, that's really was the design. And it's really hard for an average person, like even like myself, to look at a bunch of white boxes and lines and try to picture it. So the design has not been determined yet. And we're working with Krieger Klatt. They're a local architecture firm here in Royal Oak. I'm really excited, and we chose them because of their experience locally and their ability to come up with cool designs. And I've always been a design guy. I've never been a designer, but everything I've done in my career, I mean, has to fit, and really form follows the function, but the form has to be great as well. So we're really looking forward to that process, but that's really a few steps down the road. I mean, right now it's still about going through the program, negotiating with the city, the business side of things, and making sure that this still is a fit, because we're still in this infancy stage of the project and we're going through the planning process now.
Do you have any rough idea of when construction might happen on this?
Well, we're hopeful that the initial construction could start as early as the summer of next year. But a lot of that has to do with, you know, what's underneath the ground we're sitting on, the final phasing proposal that's going to be going through the planning commission. So, you know, when are we doing which project first? You know, what's going to happen to the parking? How are we dealing with a parking mitigation plan? All of that affects the timeline. So we're putting that project together now, and the only timeline that we've really set so far, which we and the city have been on target with, is having 1 year to put together this plan. So it's not like anything's been decided. We're going through that process at a very good momentum right now.
Is there anything else that people should know about you or about this project?
Yeah, I mean, I think that the biggest thing for about me is the whole reason I'm doing this is I just really want to see more tech jobs and more job growth here in southeastern Michigan. I think there's a tremendous opportunity with what's happening down in Detroit, what's happening in Midtown, what we're seeing in Royal Oak with the amount of jobs that have been created in Royal Oak, and even up through Birmingham. I think there's a way to tie together this community, and you know, I wouldn't want to see Ferndale be overpassed, because I think it's one of the most awesome, culturally appropriate, just really cool places that, you know, people like myself that are into tech and into that cultural scene and like that local community, is what we're looking for. So that's what started this whole project, and you know, even if this project doesn't go through, I'm still going to be passionate about bringing jobs in here, even if it's not with a mixed-use development, and that's really my angle on it. So I'm really excited to have the opportunity, and I appreciate everyone watching the video, taking the time, and obviously we're all in this community together. So, you know, even if you're with me or against me, you know, make sure your voices are heard, and that's part of what makes our community so special.
And how can people get information and share their feedback?
Well, the city has a website with an official email address, so definitely check that out. I'm sure you can put it up on the link here. I don't want to misquote it. That's the official way to go through. And, you know, again, we're going through that process. So there's city council meetings, there's planning commission meetings that are coming up, and we're going through it step by step. So appreciate the support, and, you know, we're excited to work with the city and the community to do something really special here.